ago on a similar rainy day, Vice Rajshekhar Reddy crashed to death and left his son Jagan Mohan Reddy's political ambitions orphaned. In a series of what has been called politically immature steps, Jagan Mohan Reddy was branded as an ambitious rebel who thought whatever belonged to his father was also his, and finally saw his exit from the Congress party. At Chatrai village in Krishna district, a rush of supporters raise slogans and crowd around Jagan Mohan Reddy. Jagan, who has been called a man in a hurry, has been keeping up a breathless morning to night touring schedule, as though it is campaign time.
Anyone would think that elections are around the corner in Andhra Pradesh. Anyone would suspect that. The mood seems to be like that.
That is how Jagan has covered more than 10,000 kilometers over 180 days ever since he began his Odarpu Yatras in April last year, ostensibly to console some 600 families who lost a relative in the shock of YSR's death. The Odarpu Yatra was frowned upon by the Congress leadership, who banned it. But Jagan turned it into a campaign vehicle to build his support base. So far, he has travelled all over the coastal and Rayalaseema regions, barring two districts, and also in Khammam district of Telangana. Today, Jagan Mohan Reddy is fighting two battles, one in a court of law and second in the political space in Andhra Pradesh. You can be forgiven for thinking that elections are round the corner here in Andhra Pradesh. That's the kind of election campaign mode that the YSR Congress party seems to be in. And Jagan Mohan Reddy is fighting really to make his political space here in Andhra Pradesh. All along his route, party loyalists have spread word that he will be arriving, and people have gathered to greet him. He stops for every group, especially the women and elderly, and has developed a unique style of contact, planting a kiss on the forehead of virtually every elderly woman in sight, blessing younger women, signing autographs.
జగనన్నం చూద్దాం రాత్రి నుంచి ఆరాట పడుతుంది రైతులు అండి మాకు రైతులకు సహాయం చేస్తున్నారు మాకు ఆయన అంటే అభిమానం ఉంది అందుకే రాజశేఖర రెడ్డి గారికి అర్థం
కొత్తగా తెచ్చారా ఎవడన్నా ఒక కొత్త పథకం తెచ్చారా కొడుకు గారు చేసిన ఇప్పుడు ఆరు వచ్చారా మాకు ఏదైనా సౌకర్యం చేస్తారని మా ఆశ మాకు కావాలని ఆరు కావాలి మాకు
కాబోయే ముఖ్యమంత్రి గారు ఆరు తెలుగుదేశం మట్టుకు నెక్స్ట్ ఉంటుంది మూడో స్థానంలో కాంగ్రెస్ ఉంటుందండి జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారు ముఖ్యమంత్రి అవుతారు అది జగన్మోహన్ రెడ్డి గారు ముఖ్యమంత్రి.
That may sound like the rhetoric of a Jagan supporter, but it's what the YSR Congress is hoping will happen. And while the mood still seems positive, they would like to see state elections sooner rather than later, especially with the heat being turned on the YSR Congress leader with the CBI probe into allegations that he used his father's position as chief minister to make money.
That is yet another statue of Vice Rajshekhar Reddy that has been unveiled by Jagan Mohan Reddy. There are hundreds, in fact thousands of such statues all over Andhra Pradesh that have come up in the last 2 years and helped to keep the YSR legacy alive. Jagan Mohan Reddy points to the crowds that are gathering around him to say that if they thought he was corrupt, they would not be flocking to him. They come because they have experienced the YSR Raj.
At every meeting, Jagan talks about the popular schemes his father introduced. Arogya Shri, a free medical insurance for the poor, the 108 ambulance service, and the fee reimbursement scheme for students, giving him all the credit instead of the Congress government. He speaks of how Sonia Gandhi rules in Delhi because of YSR and how he has been wronged by the Congress.
Yeah. NDTV's cricket app, Android and iPhone, fastest scorecard, special analysis, and much more. Download free. NDTV.com/apps.